So all of these are actually true. It is a language that we want to be able to execute using computers. We want to be able to create programs that we can actually run. It's also a language that we use to describe programs. That's the main thing we want to express with a programming language. It's designed to be easy for humans to write and for computers to execute. It's also designed to be read by humans. They're written by computers is a little tricky. We haven't talked about that yet, but many programs are written by other programs. And we've seen our first example of that, that the Python interpreter takes as input a program and runs that program. And finally, it's a language that's designed to be read and written by humans and executed by computers. And this is really the best answer, that we want the programs that we write to be things that we can use to show to other humans, to understand a process, to be able to understand what's going on. We also want to be able to execute those programs by computers. So this is one of the challenges in designing a good programming language, that in order to be easy for humans to read and write it, that makes it harder for computers to execute it. And one of the nice things about Python is it works well for both of these properties, that it is designed to be easy for humans to read and write. And with the Python interpreter, it executes well on computers. It doesn't execute as quickly as some other languages that are less focused on being easy for humans to read and write. But certainly for a first language to learn about programming, it's an excellent choice. And focusing on being easy for humans to read and write is a lot more important than making it easy for computers to execute.